Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my video series where I want to show you how to build the fastest gaming PCs for specific price categories. And today I want to show you how to build the fastest gaming PC you can currently assemble for $300. So if you don't care about RGB lighting, but you just want to play as many games as possible, you're at the right place. So first what we're going to do is go over all the parts, why we chose them, what we have to look out for. And after that I will show you some gameplays and benchmarks so you can see how this build stacks up against some other pricey gaming PCs. Now we have a lot of things to consider, so let's go ahead and let's go over our parts. The heart of our gaming PC in this price category is the AMD Ryzen 3 3200NG. This processor has 4 CPU cores with a base clock of 3.6 GHz, and it has the responsiveness and the performance you would usually expect from a much pricier processor. 6 years ago, when the first Intel processor with 4 cores and 4 GHz was introduced, you had to pay $300 for that CPU, but nowadays you get this for about a third of the price, which I personally think is just amazing. So basically, the Ryzen 3 3200G is one of the few processors that helped us a lot to finally take the leap towards really affordable gaming PCs that are actually worth building, because those PCs, they can finally play some decent video games in good quality and higher FPS. But the best thing about this processor is that it actually includes a fully functioning GPU that can render your video game graphics. The integrated Radeon Vega 8 is one of the fastest integrated GPUs that AMD has ever built. As with most AMD hardware parts, you can also overclock this one. However, this build is specifically designed to be beginner friendly and strong right out of the gate, so it's not designed for manual overclocking. However, if you are interested in overclocking, we're gonna go really in depth on this in another video. But in the end of this video, I'm gonna show you a power tip and show you exactly what you could do right away to make this processor even faster, even without overclocking. Now in Cinebench, we score a very solid result for such a low budget processor with 1,481 points. When it comes to the single core benchmark, the results are also very remarkable because we score 391 points, which is in the range of some Intel i7s, which cost way more than our processor here. It is also noteworthy that during all the benchmarks, the temperatures were very stable, even though I only used the stock cooler. And this is also very good for us because since the cooler is very solid and also included in the price, that makes the build even cheaper because we don't need to buy an extra one. So the Ryzen 3 3200G is indeed an absolute value for money monster. Of course, we also need a solid motherboard that perfectly supports our Ryzen 3. And for that, I recommend the Gigabyte GA A320M S2H. This motherboard perfectly supports the Ryzen 3 together with the necessary frequencies, the AIM4 socket and the third generation compatibility. Now, when it comes to the motherboards, this is an area where a lot of custom builders really make costly mistakes. Now, as a quick tip, I will tell you this. Don't ever buy the most expensive motherboards. Unless you know exactly what you're doing. Most of the time, it's like buying an expensive Tesla with an engine that can only drive 50 miles per hour. It looks amazing, but it doesn't make you any faster. For the motherboard, it's sufficient to support all the necessary frequencies and to have all the connectors that we need, and that's exactly the case here. However, at the same time, this motherboard is one of the cheapest ones out there, so by buying this one, you will save yourself a lot of money that you can then use to buy yourself, let's say, some more new amazing games. When it comes to the memory, we want to equip one of the two RAM slots with an 8GB RAM block from Corsair with 3200MHz. This RAM is really fast and the built-in XMP2 support ensures trouble-free and automatic overclocking. Again, we're gonna go really in depth on overclocking in another video, so make sure you hit the subscribe button. However, the fast RAM really helps the Ryzen to shine, so we shouldn't settle for less here. Also, the reason why I suggest one 8GB RAM block instead of two 4GB RAM blocks in dual channel mode is because if you want to upgrade your PC in the future, you will just be very glad to have that 8GB RAM block. As a quick note, I tested this build also with 16GB of RAM, and while RAM usually doesn't affect gaming performance too much, for some games, additional RAM specifically in this build actually gives us quite a lot of a performance boost. And the reason for that is that the integrated Vega 8 GPU actually already occupies 2GB of our RAM. However, 8GB should be enough for most cases, but just in case you want to upgrade later, I suggest buying it in the form of one block. For the disk space, as always, we rely on the classic PNY CS900 SSD with 240GB. It's really important to buy SSDs nowadays instead of HDDs because SSDs are almost as cheap as the old HDDs, but much, much faster. So in this case, you actually get the real Tesla, but for the price of an old Beetle. And for the system to always be reliably and quietly supplied with power, we use the 400W Be Quiet System Power 9 with 8+ bronze certification, all necessary protection circuits, multi-rail and a solid DC-DC technology. For the case where all the components are installed, I recommend the Corsair 100R. this is a really inexpensive mid-tower case where you have a lot of space for future upgrades like HDDs or even complete system upgrades. However, when it comes to the case, you may choose a different one because it doesn't really affect performance and it's mostly a personal preference of what's looking good. Now, I would also like to know what you think of the case or which type of cases you like the most in general. Just write in the comments below. If you do that, you might have a lot more luck in your future life. Results may vary. So now, since we are finished with all the components, let's jump into the benchmarks and game tests. Of course, I have tested this game PC in the 3D Mark x SPI benchmark, and then in the games League of Legends, Fortnite, Call of Duty Warzone, Minecraft, Witcher 3, and of course Destiny 2. And as a quick note, the results were very, very interesting. In 3D Mark x SPI, this build scores 848 overall points. The graphics score is 747, and the CPU score 3193. That's actually pretty solid, especially the CPU scores are quite good. What we can also see here is that when it comes to game performance, the GPU will be the bottleneck because the 4 cores and those 4 GHz are just really strong. And that actually also corresponds with what I saw in the gameplay tests. Now, before we start with the gameplay tests, I want to tell you a very important thing first. All the gameplays were recorded on this super low budget gaming PC. That means that the performance you will see in the tests are actually quite a little bit worse than what you could expect when you build this gaming PC yourself. Also, my recording software didn't have a lot of resources available, so it might have dropped some frames, making the gameplay looking a little less smooth than it actually was. So the first game I tested was my personal favorite of all time, League of Legends. Here I had about 100 FPS at the highest settings, so in my opinion, this gaming PC build is perfectly suited to play this game. I didn't call you off for another. I didn't cross the line for the bottle. Take me back, I know I messed it up like your father. The second game I tested was another not so resource intense game, Minecraft. Here I set the FPS to constant 60 FPS and I never dropped a single frame, so if you want to play Minecraft, you will have no problem with this $300 gaming PC. For the third game, I tested Fortnite, one of the most popular games on this planet. First, I tested at low settings where I got about 120 frames per second, and then I tested medium settings where I still got solid 60 frames per second on average. So I think when it comes to Fortnite, this PC is also very much sufficient. For the fourth game, I tested Call of Duty Warzone, which is an upcoming game that might reach the heights of Fortnite. Here I also got solid 60 FPS at low settings. With medium settings, I had about 30 FPS, which might be a little bit lower when there's a lot of action on the screen. So if you want to play this game seriously, I would recommend setting it to low settings. Now with Destiny 2, the fifth game I tested was a really resource intense game, and here was the first time I felt that this build is starting to have some problems. There wasn't a lot of difference between low and medium settings and the FPS were mostly at 30, but I also had some frame drops, especially when there was a lot of action ongoing. So for Destiny 2, I recommend a better computer, for example the $500 gaming PC build that I recommend in another video. I will leave the link in the description. Now the last game I tested was Witcher 3. I know from experience that this game needs a lot of GPU RAM and therefore I wanted this to be the last and the toughest test for our gaming PC. And after having seen the results, I have to admit that if you want to play Witcher 3, I would also recommend at least the $500 gaming PC build that I go through in depth in another video. We'll be right back. Now, these were all the gameplay tests that I made, and I have to say that I'm actually very impressed about how solid this low-budget gaming PC really is. There has never been a better time for low-budget gaming PCs because the Intel and the AMD rivalry brought the prices down so much in this segment that we can now enjoy so many high-quality games with such small budgets. Now let me give you one of the two power tips, and the first one is to upgrade your BIOS. CPUs are separated in generations and come with different drivers. And because motherboards do that too, we should always make sure that these fit together. Now, because the Ryzen 3 is of the third generation and the motherboard I recommend in this video does sometimes have an older BIOS depending on when it was manufactured, we should make sure to update that as soon as we first start using it. The second power tip I also want to give you is to manually update your CPU drivers. Very often they are not being updated automatically, and very often it really makes a huge difference. For example, with all those manual updates, I got the 3D mark results from 767 to almost 843 because the driver update automatically calibrated my CPU and GPU settings. Now, if you think those FPS weren't enough for you and that you want to build something that has more power, then you should make sure to check out my $500 gaming PC video where I go in depth on how to build a gaming PC in that price category. But before you go there, this video took a lot of time and effort and I try to make it as good as possible. So if you want to support a small creator fighting against the billion-dollar businesses on YouTube, then make sure to leave a like. And if you're really generous, share this video with a friend, even if it's just because of the awesome music at the end of this video. Thanks for watching.